Hey, welcome back.
Welcome back.
We're in a bit of a situation here.
Right.
But
the helicopter can't see you if you sneak out.
Yeah, let's hope.
Alright, so, no, go to your right.
You see an exit?
Yeah. It's kind of, you have to follow that wall. It's on your left now.
I'm gonna crawl. I'm less visible.
They're looking
that way. That helicopter is right above me.
Yeah, so it's just up this way.
Oh yeah, I see. Thank you, Rebels, for dying for me. Oh, shit. Oh, that's one of my buddies. Okay, cool.
Yeah. Wait, that guy behind him.
Yeah, he was another Rebel. I saw his hat.
Oh, okay.
He's wearing those dumb Rebel hats.
Fair enough.
Okay.
Alright.
That's one more map cleared. I forgot how much actual gameplay is in this chapter.
Yeah, so far we haven't really been interrupted that much.
Yeah, this isn't very Metal Gear of it. I don't know if I should be disappointed or happy. It's a world gone mad.
Oh, shit. That's some definite dudes up there.
Who? What are
you doing? It's just
me. Never mind what I'm doing here.
It's your friend Snake. Don't mind
me. Alright, and they're engaging those guys, so...
Yeah, you go ahead and do that, guys.
Oh. Hi. This shit's about to get thick in this spot. Right.
Let's go! Over there!
Gotcha.
Assault rifle.
Man, this is just pure chaos.
It really is.
It's very different from your usual, like, sneaking Metal Gear stuff.
Yeah.
Which I kind of like it.
Yeah, it's a different take on the...
Battlefield stealth, I think, is what they were calling it.
Yeah.
It's kind of also just Acts 1 and 2, but it's like this.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. Uh-oh, something's happening.
It's a cutscene!
Oh, I got one of your... Oh, it's that thing from the prologue.
The rebels have got an armored dozer. They're probably going to use it to bust their way into the mansion. Give it some cover and it might get you inside the compound.
Sure. Can help. Definitely.
Oh!
Oh yeah!
Oh yeah! Well, look at all those presents.
And all these DPs. I'm kind of reluctant to spend too much of my money until later acts, because they can give her weapons in the shop, but...
Yeah.
You know what, it's not a big deal, really.
Yeah. I mean, this isn't like Borderlands, where you have to keep upping your damage.
It's
you just need it to have bullets to kill things.
I like killing things with bullets.
Yeah.
It's fun.
Charge! Cover!
I think something about my controller, there's a certain space on the left stick where, like, it struggles a bit. It's hard to explain.
Naomi's lab is somewhere inside those mansion grounds. Proceed immediately.
I know you're out there, somewhere out there.
Oh man, this is, like, setting for, like, an 80s action movie.
It totally is, isn't it?
Yeah. Like where the drug dealer would live. Oh, they're just like executing all your rebel fuckers.
I know. So sad.
So sad.
I don't know if I can peek out. Oh, I think I can with this one. Okay. Cool. Nice shot. Lazy to make those headshots when my stress and my psych is good.
We got company! Back me up!
Oh, this dude is spooky. Something bad's gonna happen.
What bad things never happen in Metal Gear? You're crazy. Yeah, you're crazy.
You're crazy. Xbox, you're crazy.
Now, can you imagine a Kinect Metal Gear game?
Get down!
That sounds amazing.
No way, they need a game with all sorts. Oh, some music.
I saw an iPod thing.
Sailor. Suppressing fire. All right. Vulcan, the Rave Man. Something comes out of a can. Hi, guy. Good, you sneak.
You just gonna stand there?
He's just waiting for his opportunity.
Okay. Good job. Carry on.
Oh. I want some more of your fuckers.
Oh, yeah. They're not doing so well.
No, you need to help them out or something.
And I guess I don't have to. There we go.
Oh, they got a sniper on the roof. That's why they're getting owned. Oh, that guy's getting ready to take care of them. Snipers on the roof.
You guys got this handled.
Yeah, totally.
I just went, oh, wow. I want all these DPs. Did that guy just accidentally kill his own man?
Maybe.
Is that what just happened there?
Maybe. These are like... Oh, the guy behind you just died. I'm going to take his gun to you now.
Eh, everything's fine. Nothing to see here.
That should be the catchline for all our Metal Gear playthroughs.
Nothing to see here.
Everything's fine, nothing to see here. Meanwhile, shit's going bad. Good idea.
I'm inside the house.
Not a bad place.
Not at all. I have no idea if they still know I'm here or not. I think they're just fighting the rebels.
Yeah.
I think we're good.
You're probably okay.
Got grenade.
Grenade. That could be like a magazine ad to have like a guy with like a burnt off stump. And it's like, got grenade. He's like giving a thumbs up with the one hand he has left. Is that insensitive? I don't know.
Couldn't tell. Also, I have no idea where I am.
I have no idea
what
you're
doing. But someone saw me!
Like those two!
Bye!
Sure, why not?
You know what? This is a good upgrade. I'm glad we bought this upgrade. This was an excellent idea.
Yeah.
Oh, this is a big house.
It is. I mean, it is a mansion. Oh, sweet. Got a playboy.
What a playboy.
What a playboy.
Ooh. Ooh.
Ooh, a mortar.
Hello.
Awesome.
Hey, those are my people, though, right?
Yeah, those are definitely your people.
So where's not my people? Where are you guys? Is that a soldier down there? I can't reach him.
Soldier boy. Oh, that guy's not your guy.
Bye. Aw. Wee! Aw, someone got him first.
Yeah.
Or that might have been me. It might have just been a big delay. I see. Yeah. I get it.
You're doing like a ridiculous high angle shot.
Yeah.
How mortars work.
But, cool, that's fun. I don't even remember ever doing that. I think that entire building was optional.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Maybe.
Oh, wait, don't go down.
I think I am going down now.
Now, go for it.
Okay, ooh. I did want to go in there. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Secret tunneloo.
There's always a secret tunnel. Claymores.
Yay!
I can't remember if you have to go through this or not.
Hey, it's a little mouse. Ooh, there is a lot of stuff. Some more grenades. Oh.
I'm full on some of that. Compressed ration.
Raiding the wine cellar. Finding all the things. Oh, yeah. Research lab.
This is what I want.
Sweet.
I did it. I beat Metal Gear.
Game over. Good game. Would rate 8 out of 8.
Eight point system, huh?
Yep.
I like it. It's
great
different.
Great mate would rate 8 out of 8.
Butt shot?
Sneaky!
Butt shot!
Yeah.
It's another ladder thing, but he's so old that he can only go over a short ladder, so...
Yeah.
We can't do the full Snake Eater anymore.
Yeah.
Shake that controller. Hey, Naomi. Shoot her!
Well, she's probably actually evil. Who knows?
Isn't everyone, really?
Yeah.
Actually, it seems these games, the ones you think are evil are good, and the ones you think are good are evil, and the ones that seem neutral are just double-crossing everyone.
Yeah. Oh, there's someone else in there.
It's like a first-person shooter.
Eh. Need the Doom music over that.
There's a new Doom coming, and it looks... I don't know. It looks weird.
Yeah, I don't... I stopped caring about that game when I turned, like, 13, so...
I mean, legendary series in its own way. Like, it's important.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Doesn't mean I have to care about it anymore.
Yeah, it just doesn't really do much for me. And I like some shooters, just...
Yeah.
Doom is just a shooter-ass shooter.
I mean, you gotta set yourself out. So that's why I like Borderlands and...
Yeah.
I mean, to... Mix that Battlefront, Star Wars Battlefront.
Yeah, that new one. I'm excited.
Yeah.
I know. Me too.
Damn it, Snake. Why? Why is she walking around? Is it really hot here? It's not hot here because it's at 17 degrees.
Did it?
Yeah, on, like, little kind of, like, mini-map.
Oh, I never even noticed the temperature was there.
Yeah, it was, like, cloudy, 17 degrees.
Huh.
Something about the humidity, but... Come on, Naomi.
Kept you waiting, huh?
Come on, people who designed Naomi's model.
I knew you'd come.
Is the first time we actually see her in-game, but instead of, like...
Yeah, she was also in the Kodak.
Yeah.
Why?
What did my boyfriend have to do with this?
Not many people could recognize 4D sound data in a Soliton radar file. How is the good doctor?
Good doctor? He's a piece of shit. He's the same as ever. Yeah, a piece
same
of
as
shit.
Ever.
Liquid. Although I suppose he's really Ocelot. From a medical standpoint.
What?
I thought he was here.
Uh-oh.
He's not. At the moment.
Your decoy friend is here.
Where are all the guards?
They know I won't escape. I'm powerless to resist. I've no choice but to cooperate.
You'll always be my Sheena from Tales of Symphonia. Jennifer Hale.
Sheena was pretty great.
Yeah. I think that's probably my first introduction to Jennifer Hale, so.
I think mine was MGS1, actually.
Oh, yeah, huh?
Either that or Knights of the Old Republic.
What you saw was
I never really played either of those, so. I can't think of what else she's in. I mean, it's like all the things, but. Damn you, blatant cleavage!
Sigh.
You don't trust me. Maybe I'm just saying that so it hides the fact that maybe I like it. First.
Liquid. We thought the SOP was an ID control system designed primarily to maintain order and control in battle. And we were right.
It's a distracting shirt.
It's very distracting.
And no one would do that. No respectable scientist.
SOP had another function.
I mean, again, it's just... It's that weird thing that we always encounter. It's like, well, if she was a person in real life and she chose to wear her shirt like that, then that's on her.
Yeah.
That's cool. Do whatever you want. But chances are whoever made that model is probably a dude.
It's like, just check out this sick cleavage, yo.
Yeah. I mean, you could argue that in character... I mean, if people in real life can make that decision, then the made-up characters can also make that decision. Except it's still a person making the decision for them. So I don't know, it's fucked up.
In other words, meanwhile, nanomachines.
Yeah.
The skyrocketing demands of the war economy have fueled the demand for more soldiers and more fighting. This, in turn, led to the development of technologies to rapidly improve their combat abilities.
End of the day, if you want to find boots, it's not hard to find boots.
There's boobs everywhere.
Someone's going to do it.
But you, of all people, must understand, Snake, that unlike combat technique, a soldier's senses can't be taught. They must be earned through experience.
Does this have something to do
test
with
test file?
You need to grind low-level enemies.
To release the soldiers' nanomachines from the system. But we didn't know about the med...
Wait, what the fuck? I don't know
you
what
pull
happened
the Tyler!
There. Which is weird, because I didn't even press the button.
No. Our test was a success. At least it confirmed our hypothesis at the time. Just as we predicted, the nanomachine stopped functioning, and the PMC soldiers were freed from the grips of the system. But the moment the system stopped, all the pain and fury and sorrow, all the trauma and stress, all the hatred, regret, guilt, all the sensations that had been suppressed were unleashed within their hearts.
Ooh.
Their memories.
That's gotta suck.
Weren't erased.
Each enemy crawling in their skin, yo. Lost those wounds, they just won't heal.
Each threat of violence against the innocent. Every act of war they'd committed was etched firmly in their hearts.
So it's like condensed PTSD.
Yeah, that keeps coming up, like you said.
Yeah.
The user's body rejects the nanomachines. This reaction must then be suppressed with drugs. Before the user knows it, his mind is in complete shambles. Snake, remember Frank?
Frank Yeager. Great box.
Oh, yeah.
For their experiments and nullified his broken heart. Nanomachines.
SOP. What ever happened to Frank?
He died.
He got. We killed him, didn't we?
Well, he died against Smilgy Rex.
Oh, right.
Liquid stomped him into paste.
The meaning.
Right.
He's pretty gross.
Yeah.
Until that point, war was like a game to them.
And
then suddenly, reality came crashing down.
It's all a game.
Ordinarily, our hearts are hardened through experience.
Oh, Kojima.
Grizzled veterans live with an inescapable guilt.
Yeah.
Bit by bit through the years. And even then, it never truly goes away. For a mind lacking that essential experience... simply too much to bear.
Oh, Snake. You did that on purpose.
100%.
We've been under the system's control.
Or haven't you?
I know.
It's exhausting.
I know.
Wait, it's hard being a so-called justice warrior. I kind of, like, get it, you know, it's like, if you want to actually give a shit, it takes effort.
Yeah.
It's just so much easier to say, like, fuck it, it doesn't hurt nobody.
She wants to take her clothes off.
Oh.
Snake, what It's gotten into you.
Nanomachines?
I hate girls. I only undress for Icon.
What?
Snake.
So old.
But he's so ripped. What? What's wrong? I don't get it.
Right. Let's just get this over with.
Yes. Of course.
Maybe she was sexually attracted to him, and now he's got an old man body, and she's like, no!
Oh, you're worthless to me! I mean, I guess all the splotchy bits are kind of gross, but yeah. I don't know, I don't get it.
Maybe he smells like old people.
That's actually, like, false.
I know.
There's no such thing as old person smell.
The ones you stuck me with at Moses.
I mean, we all smell like the stuff we have around us, and...
They won't stop
you know, if you have...
until they're all extracted. Or until you do. Most of them were lost through bleeding and excretion, but around 30% still remain inside your body, attached to your cells, not finished yet. The first generation were never ID.
Well, this is getting weird.
React in the same way as the SOP nanomachines. But they may be interfering with your body and with your heart.
So, does the aging have something to do with Fox diet too?
No. Your telomeres were intentionally set up to be short, regardless of the age of the original. One of the genes that inhibit reproduction and aging, the Clotho gene, was intentionally mutated as well. But more importantly, your chromosomes, like liquids, were provided with terminator genes to prevent them from making copies.
Why?
There's little Arnolds in there.
For one purpose. So, in order to prevent you from being abused by,
I can just imagine like a little like Arnie-shaped parasites, and then like every time like little spermies are like, "All right, we're going on our mission," and they're like, "No, you are not going anywhere." That was terrible. I'm sorry.
That's a dick move. Make a clone and intentionally make it so he can't have kids, and it's gonna age really super fast.
Yeah. I've gone through a machine like that once.
It's your natural lifespan.
Yeah, I was in one of them. Yeah, for kidney stone stuff.
Yeah. I think they're doing a lot of tests on me when I first had my seizures.
Oh, yeah, I keep forgetting that's the thing that happens to you.
Yeah, it hasn't happened in a few years now, but...
That's good.
Yeah.
Seizures suck.
They sure do!
I've been told. They are not a fun thing.
No, it's kind of scary.
One might argue they are the opposite of fun.
Although I've always been too tired to actually be scared when it was happening, but... it's just a weird series of events, you know?
Yeah.
Thinking you're awake, then all of a sudden, what? Now I'm in a different spot.
Yay.
Your cells, blood, organs...
It's kind of like teleporting, time traveling.
Muscle tissue. Every part
except,
of
like,
your
body when you're done time traveling, you're like... Your body just is, like, pretty much useless. You feel like you're weak as fuck.
Snake,
she's copying you!
Keeping you together is the strength of your will.
How long do I have?
Half a year.
You know what? I don't blame you losing some psyche for that, Snake. That's fair. No!
Don't.
It doesn't matter. You're gonna die in 6 months. What? How is smoking gonna make a difference?
There's something I have to tell you.
Now what?
You and I both know your body is approaching its limit. But when I said half a year, I wasn't talking about your lifespan.
What?
What do you mean?
We can't get rid of the fox dye in your body completely. At this point, it's circulating within you like a normal virus.
Yeah, so?
Listen to me. fox dye only kills its victims when the infected person's genetic code fully matches the genetic sequence programmed into the virus's receptors. In other words, it only attacks targets with specific genes.
Yeah, that's right. I couldn't hear what you're saying there, your boobs.
Plus, we know this from the first game.
Yeah. Whoa.
And at the same time, it's set up to protect those not designated as targets from the virus's harmful effects. Here, I'll show you. The receptors on the fox dye inside your body are breaking down. The rapid aging process is changing the environment within your body. As a result, the virus is starting to mutate.
Soon you'll have laser eyes.
Sweet.
The viruses on the left are fox dye in its original form. The ones on the right I took from your body. They're already mutated. The receptors, they're wearing down.
Meaning?
This mutated version of fox dye could activate even if the infected person's genetic pattern doesn't perfectly match the receptors. Which means the virus is becoming indiscriminate about what type of target it kills.
Someone's here. Look up behind you.
Ever since Shadow Moses, fox dye has been breeding continuously in the nanomachine.
Oh no, that's a printer. Yeah. I thought I heard like someone like sneaking up on them.
Yeah, there was kind of a scratching sound. Yeah.
However, if the receptors continue to wear down, it'll become a killer virus that attacks untold numbers of victims.
What if we kill them all? Remove them from the body?
There are no antibodies either. I don't know what percentage of the receptors have to break down, or how many people will be targeted when that happens. But what is certain is that people will begin to catch fox dye through airborne transmission. It'll start with those closest to you. Then, one by one, they'll lose their lives.
That sucks.
Yeah, it's pretty shitty.
The part of the virus that distinguishes between individuals will start to break down in about...
half a year.
No. 3 months at the most.
3 months?
Yeah. Oh, God.
You've spent
it's like rain on your wedding day.
Saving the world from Metal Gear. From nuclear annihilation. And now... becoming a doomsday device yourself. I can't predict exactly how devastating the epidemic will be. Whether just 1% of the human race could unlock the broken receptors, or whether we all can. In either case, 3 months from now, you'll be a walking biological weapon.
Well, fuck.
Damn it.
If it were up to me, be quarantined.
Snake hasn't had the greatest life.
No.
It's not over yet.
Not over yet.
I know. You still have a job to do. You have 3 months. Still enough time to think once all of this is done with.
And if I choose death first, will that stop fox dye from spreading?
I did a good job with the facial animations.
Yeah.
Especially for like a 2008 game.
Yeah.
Like, there's games that do it better now, but... definitely more emotive than previous Metal Gears.
Snake, tell me one more thing.
Do you like me?
Mm.
Would you go to the prom with me?
Lately?
Yeah.
While you were there, did they give you an injection?
Don't they always?
Take a look at this. These came out of your body as well. It's a new strain of fox dye, one I've never
seen. Uh-oh.
Someone must have put them in you recently. Do you have any idea who?
Him.
The new fox dye strain is starting to multiply rapidly.
Mm-hmm.
What's in it?
Trevin injected him in Act 1.
Oh, yeah.
Here, take this. It contains the same substance the soldiers' nanomachines secrete inside their bodies. It's a drug that inhibits the nanomachines' ability to regulate the senses. The nanomachines inside the body malfunction when the system...
Sorry, nanomachines?
It triggers
a... Oh, yeah, nanomachines are a thing.
Oh, right, nanomachines.
Yeah, yeah.
Give yourself a
Have you heard, lately, nanomachines?
No, I haven't.
Oh. Well, I discovered this because nanomachines...
Oh, cool. Yeah. That's interesting.
Yeah.
I never thought of that.
Yeah, it's probably because you don't nanomachines.
Invalid?
Invalid?
Restore your psyche for a short while, but use it too often and the amount restored will start to decrease.
I love when they start talking about game mechanics in the middle of, like, story cutscenes. Use the action button, Snake.
Snake, use I've been a fool. The drugs.
I let myself drown
also,
my
nanomachines. Ah, nanomachines.
Boobs.
Nanomachines. Nanoboobs.
I can't slip free.
I had a friend who one time just said, just to be weird, he was like, can you imagine if that wall over there was just boobs?
That'd be scary.
Yeah, I'm like, yeah, that would be terrifying.
I can't tell you yet. Not until
yet.
You free me.
Free you how?
No. Liquid left here last night.
Where was he headed?
Those are my terms. I can't leave this place of my own will.
What are you talking about?
Nanomachines.
I'm being...
Yep. Now I have to hide while you
Liquid
fight the boss.
Plan.
Nanomachines.
Removing the system will only cause his army to collapse from within.
Collapse from nanomachines.
He's chosen to seize control instead.
Nanomachines.
Liquid's objective is to hijack the
nanomachines.
Who could it be?
He'll use it to create the ultimate
it's Dr. Octopus. Medusa head.
Superior Spider-Man.
Whoa.
There's a name for his new plan.
Yeah, Disney bought Metal Gear. Just like they buy every time.
Yeah, of course.
That's the subtitle of the game. Yay!
See that? Oh. Uh-oh. That's Mantis. That was quick.
Well, you know, you can't blame me for that fuck up because it was cutscene snake.
Yep.
Unless the game just, like, reads your files. Like, okay, you've played poorly, so...
Yeah.
Snake's gonna suck in cutscenes, too. You know what? That's actually something I can see Kojima doing. That is absolutely something I can see him doing.
Well, Snake, you're FWA. Hello.
Octo camo.
Octo camo. Paula Tiso and Fred Tatasciore. Awesome!
Do you know either of those names?
Yeah, I mean, the Fred Tatasciore is like in everything. Yeah, drama. I'm gonna have to like look up a specific character, but yeah, he's totally in everything. So
right.
This is our boss fight?
First boss fight!
Alright. It's good because this thing looks the most terrifying.
Yeah, it's cool design.
Surrounded, Snake. You'll have to break through to go after Nathan.
Really? Like, thanks, Otacon.
Otacon's helpful.
Okay.
It's actually not the boss fight yet. I gotta fight these frogs first.
I did spell it right. Age 48.
Once again, looking up voice actors.
That's my favorite part of playing these games.
The cruise control tradition.
Yep. Alright.
Gotcha.
That is a good upgrade to have.
Oh, wow. Oh. That did not kill them. That killed them.
Yeah. Oh, you should know that. They don't... They're not dead until they turn into fire.
Remember?
Alright. Two down. Four down. Come on. Come get me.
Come on. Get me. Compress.
Oh. Oh, they're coming into the ceiling.
Ah.
Shit.
Hi, fella. No! Lady. Sold P90.
Oop.
477 things.
Wow.
Yeah, like you're I right. said, everything.
He is in everything, holy shit. V-ring, whatever that is.
V-ring? It's like a cock ring, but for your V.
Oh, okay.
Yep. Apparently he's going to be Mighty Number 9.
I wasn't even sure if Mighty Number 9 had voice acting.
Apparently it will.
Apparently.
And it's going to have Steve Bloom.
Well, now there's a guy who's excellent at everything.
Yep. Oh, I can't even remember. I think of a different Bloom. No, I'm thinking of Doc Brady. Oh yeah, he's a... Like a lot of side characters in our family, right?
Now the boss fight.
Now the boss fight.
Hello.
He's Hulk in the newest current Avengers cartoon. As long as many other characters.
That's interesting. I did not recognize the name.
Yeah. Oh, apparently he plays Hulk a lot. Oh, he's just generic munition guy in Arkham Knight. Plop. It's a decoy! Or is it?
Shooter!
It's like she has a Metal Gear on her head.
Kinda.
And it looks more like a squid than an octopus.
Yeah, it looks like a blooper.
Yeah.
Bloop, bloop.
It's all so fucking hysterical! Whoa! F-bomb!
I believe that is the first F-bomb in Metal Gear.
Whoa, landmark. You got really pointy boobs, lady. I mean, I wouldn't know because I wasn't looking, but... This stuff. Tor.
Alright. Oh god. Okay. Starting off by shooting me. Good times.
The lions. What?
I don't remember how difficult this fight is.
Oh.
So we'll see.
Sneak, sneak, sneak. Sneak, sneak, sneak. Sneak your butt off.
Wait a second.
Wait a second.
Oh, she's shooting these little grenade things. Okay.
Alright. So sweet animation.
Well, I hurt her a teeny tiny little bit.
Yay!
So, you know, progress. Oh god, she just burst out of the fucking ceiling.
Oh.
That sucks. That barely hurts her.
Can you do some shots while she's like just lying on the ground like that, or is she kind of...
I think she protects herself.
Watch your health. Yeah. I don't know which one's health is. Is it the bar or the...
It's the big one.
Okay.
Yeah, the top bar.
Cool.
Oh.
Oh.
I used to looking at the voice actor.
It's just hilarious. Like on some of these shows, he does like all the voices. It's hilarious.
Yeah, that happens in a lot of stuff. Like, one voice actor will keep doing multiple things.
Like, yeah, I think this guy, like, he does, like, a lot of, He does a lot of the extra voices for a lot of stuff. He's already been in at least three of the games we've played so far.
She's hiding.
Hiding.
Whoa.
Oh, sneaky.
Oh, I'm out of grenades. Okay.
Oh no!
I tried firing one and didn't go so well.
Oh no. Oh, that was the city XCOM.
There was a shitty XCOM?
Yep. There was one where they made it like a first-person shooter. Remember hearing about that?
Oh, yeah, okay. I actually heard it wasn't that bad.
Ah, fair enough. I guess just a lot of, like, fans of the series were pissed off, because that's not XCOM. That's just XCOM theme.
Hey. Thank you, Solid Eye. You're kind of helping me a little.
What is she camouflaged as this time? Oh.
It's close.
She play a snake and hiding in the box. Snake.
Nope.
Oh, you got her. Yeah.
This is actually a neat fight.
This is pretty cool.
She's using my tricks against me.
He's zero tool? Fuck, too?
Oh, really?
Nice.
Neat.
He's also, like I said, he's been Hulk in, like, pretty much anything that's been in the last 5 years. So, including, like, Marvel Heroes. Alright. Oh, she shoots out ink.
Of course. You're a squid now. You're a kid now.
Squid. Squid now. Kid now. Squid now. Kid now.
I wonder. I should be trying to use something stronger. I don't know, I guess I'm doing okay damage to her.
Yeah, slowly but surely, as long as you don't run out of wrath and...
Which I think I still have a decent amount. I have 5 noodles and 3 rations.
Okay, so
yeah, that's not bad.
Warcraft.
Where are you, Lee? Oh, is she?
Oh! That wasn't there before.
Yeah, there was one on the other side. Sneaky lady.
Awesome.
Where'd you go?
Oh. Uh-oh.
Snake, come here.
What the?
Wait a second.
Otacon, what's wrong? Why are you calling me over there?
Huh? What are you talking about?
Chicky.
I'm telling you, I didn't call you. This is no time for jokes. You're supposed to be fighting Octopus. Come on.
Hey, Otacon.
That should be a line. I wouldn't actually just mind having that on the press of a button. You should be fighting Octopus. Out of context, that's hilarious.
I wonder if I can call him again now. There isn't as much codex stuff in those previous games.
Octopus's suit seems to work the same way as your octo camo.
Yeah, we know that.
Mimicry and traps as weapons against you. Stay focused. Don't be deceived by its disguise.
I haven't been, thank you very much. Because I'm a smart game player, man.
Binary strategy.
Oh, God.
Hi! Bye!
Alright, where'd you go? I don't like all this creepy laughing. Oh, you were like, wait a second.
Tend to be a body! That's sneaky.
Whoa!
Whoa!
Ow.
She pretended to be a barrel.
Do a barrel roll, get it?
Oh, what?
Shit.
Oh, fuck.
Well.
I think I had to keep shooting her while she's in ball form there.
She's invincible then. I needed to climb up on something else, I think. Hey, we're going to try that fight again next time on Cruise Control.
Looks like we'll see you tomorrow.